Before viewing the results of our admin portal, we need to add a few details to configure our API. We will start by opening up the settings.py file located in the project directory. Within this file, we will be adding an object called REST framework to configure the default pagination settings for our API. I've added this object above the database for convenience. The REST framework includes options for custom pagination, which allows you to split the resulting data into individual pages. There are a few options for pagination links. You can place the pagination links in the content of the response or in the response headers. The default style returns the links for the previous and next pages in the content of the response. We will use the default style to return the links within the content of the response instead of the headers. We will be setting the pagination style globally by using the default pagination class key with the value page number pagination from restframework.pagination. This pagination style accepts a single number in the request query parameters, which determines the current page. Within the response body, the links for the next and previous pages are returned. Next, we will specify the page size key and add a page size of 10 objects per page. Lastly, we need to add the REST framework to our list of installed applications to enable the application within this Django installation. In the next video, we will demonstrate the browsable API and see how it can be used. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.